when Andy's not on the road. Even during rehearsals, Sam's never far from Andy's side.
This, I think he's cleaning his paws right now. That's my Sam.
This is Sam.
Yeah.
Sam is such a nice dog.
He is.
Do you have any idea what his lineage is? He seems to be a little of this and a little of that.
Oh, it's very regal. Sam, from what I can work out, here's a kiss. Sam is, well, what he looks to me is a cross-collie shepherd.
And you don't know, right?
I don't know, because he came from the pound. There's no pedigree, so.
Now, tell me about this. You've had Sam for how long?
I've had Sam now going on 2 years.
And you got him from the pound?
Got him from the pound, yep.
And how did you end up, were you shopping for a dog? Did you go specifically to go buy a dog?
I'll tell you how it happened. I came out of an unhappy relationship, and I was just, I just needed a companion, like an animal or something, and I went out to look for a dog at the pound. Because I don't like purebred dogs. I always think they're very arrogant, and I just don't have much time for them. So I went to the pound just to see. I didn't really expect to get anything at all. And I went down there and I saw Sam, which I called him later, and fell in love with him. And I think somebody must have lost him. Someone's going to see this now and claim him, watch. So I think somebody lost him because he's been trained and everything. And, but he became my best friend.
Well, now, how old do you think he is? He's not a two-year-old. He wasn't a pup when you got him, right?
No. I presume he's about 11 or 12 years old.
Really?
I think. I really don't know. He's got no teeth. I know that.
And he's got that sort of mellow demeanor of an older dog.
Yeah, he's a very, very good dog to have in the house because he's just there, and he's never barking or like a nuisance or doing things on the carpet he shouldn't do.
Well, he's such a great dog, and I can see why you love him so much.
Yep.
But it's kind of rare for people to go and get an older dog. What made you decide to do that?
Again, like I said, I really didn't go looking for anything specifically. I just found Sam, and they were going to put him to sleep about 3 days later if I didn't take him.
Are you kidding?
So I paid my $30 and I took him home.
$30?
Yeah. But he became, you know, he's one of those dogs. It's like something out of like Lassie or something. He's always by my side. If I go out for a walk, he just stays by my side. He's quiet. He'll jump in the car and go anywhere with you. And he became my best friend. He would know when I was depressed or down or whatever. And he felt a lot of things for me.
You said that you got him after a relationship had split up.
Uh-huh.
What, you know, we all go through the whole myriad of anger and sadness and everything. How did Sam react to that?
I don't know. Sam's never been through it.
To you going
through it. You've ever split up with a girl before, Sam?
He's old enough. He's been around.
I think he has, yes. You hussy. I think he sensed it, because I think animals do sense those things with humans. And if I was just down or depressed or thinking, you know, because I was living alone in my ranch house, he would just come up to me and put his nose under my arm, lift it up, and just look at me and whimper a little bit. Uh-huh. And then he would just lay by my feet. He always knew when I was depressed. Now I'm happy. He doesn't give me the time of day, do you?
I know. He loves to be here at rehearsal, I guess. He doesn't mind the loud music?
No, not at all. Sometimes he comes down. He just, he likes to be around people. And he just likes to lay down in front of the speakers and listen.
Well, he seems like a one-man dog. He's very nice to everybody, but he always knows where you are.
Yeah. He loves that. Yes, he always sort of, whenever I'm away, as mad as he is when I come back, he sleeps outside my bedroom door. And he won't leave that usually. He just spends most of his time outside the door.
Is he sort of protective?
No. I think if a burglar came to the house, he'd let them in and show them around. You know?
Friendly
come
old
here,
guy.
Come here. Let me show you the candelabras.
You think
over
this
here.
Is good? Come look at the piano.
Yeah. Got a few $1,000 over here in the drawer.
Well, I want to ask you a personal question. This is about, you know, your relationship with Sam. You said you met him at the breakup of a relationship.
That's right.
Now, he probably feels that he's very, very important in your life now.
I think he does.
When you get involved again in another relationship, what's he going to feel like?
I don't know. I think, well, he loves women, so. You like the Gibbs, aren't you? You love your women, yeah.
So he's just biding his time.
Oh, I think he'd love it. I don't think that would, it certainly wouldn't change my feelings for him. And I.